These views are called state transition diagrams. They're essentially graphical representations of a finite state machines. In these diagrams, we have an indication of a node, typically with an oval or some kind of rectangle. We have arcs, directed arcs connecting the nodes, indicating that there's a state transition. The arcs can be labeled. The arcs can be labeled with an action and a transition. Typically, the actions can be optional. Usually, but not always, the transitions are not optional. Okay? If you recall your finite state machines from theory, there are these epsilon transitions. We'll see, in fact, that the garage door opener has one of these, but they're not all that typical. Note that the layout of the nodes, where we place them in the diagram, doesn't have any semantic import, so you are free to make the diagram lay it out in a way that conveys what you consider to be the important behavioral aspects of the system. In terms of how these diagrams work, you can think of yourself as, at any point in time, being in a specific state, okay, kind of waiting there until an event happens. When the event happens, the outgoing arcs are examined to determine whether any of them are labeled with the corresponding event, and if so, a transition is made between the current state and the state at the end of that transition, and in so doing, the action, if any, on that transition arc is executed.